And please start with you, Michael. As we're aware, Bill H.R. 841 is in Congress. What's your opinion of this bill, and what does this mean if it passes for hemp companies?
Well, let me start with H.R. 841. It's a pretty good bill. It's introduced. It would create a lawful pathway for dietary supplements that contain hemp or CBD. And it would make it clear that every other regulatory requirement that applies to every other herbal ingredient or botanical constituent also applies to hemp and CBD dietary supplements. So that's the first thing that it would mean for hemp companies if it passes. You're treated just like any other dietary supplement. If there's a flaw in this legislation from the broad CBD industry perspective, it's that it applies only to dietary supplements. So it will not create a lawful pathway for food or beverage products that have added CBD. The thinking on this is that we should try to get the more achievable task done first. So get dietary supplements now and then come back later and see if we can get the pathway established for foods. Will it pass? It's got 23 co-sponsors, including 15 Democrats and 8 Republicans. So that's a sign of some broad support. There's not a companion bill in the Senate, though. And the Food and Drug Administration has made it clear that it wants a number of amendments made before further consideration is given to the bill. We've heard that the House Energy and Commerce Committee will likely schedule a hearing on this bill and possibly on the broader issue of cannabis decriminalization. So that too is a good sign. We've got the attention of the Congress. But we've also heard that House Energy and Commerce will want to include or at least consider inclusion of some of FDA's requested amendments. Some of these we could probably live with and even support, authorizing FDA to prescribe specific labeling requirements, for example, and amending the definition under law of a prohibited act in a manner that would help FDA get those darn drug spike products off the market. But we're also concerned about some of FDA's requests, for example, to let the agency establish a quantitative limit on the amount of CBD that would be allowed in any dietary supplement product, or removing the grass option for a company to meet its pre-market safety obligations. And I know we're going to talk about that in a lot more detail. And then let me leave with, there's also a lot of opposition that's been expressed by a number of the so-called consumer groups who are, in my view, attempting to hold hemp hostage in order to force a number of broad changes to the overall dietary supplement law. So that's maybe a place we can begin the conversation.